mano na ako.
Okay?
The women, advert. Trees, all the people to us, all there are some places in the world, some countries. Can I hear? fatto poi a vedere l'environmental
and then this
yeah only to go to see then the apple plays in the back or I know that good to in the way
that's it
they can
also
ambition. Ambition
so all that are informed and then according to the water
I the oxygen
so now you have got a number of the best.
The smart magazine I got today. Even those who say they're not coming in the room. And I'm enjoying that. A game and invite and I'm going to tell you that. You don't mind playing a negative, then those who saw that game in the last 1 year.
You remember your mother?
My mother. And preferably, how could they be able to look at my life? I'm going to be around here. So, my name is crude oil of water, and we abandon the other oil. But it was bad. I can only the huge potentials. Malaysia came to the Eastern region and took farms away. Where they were back. Even the Malaysia then went by exporting palm produce, and even Nigeria then went by exporting crude oil. I am an MS import, including the crude seedling from Malaysia.
Hello? Hello? Good morning, we who have a new book is going to try to do it.
I'm
I didn't know to go back, nobody knows to go back with the photo. Oh, no, to go back with the photo. My grandma was on Apple.
Thank you. Major points. Everyone from America, everyone from
Chukwuma government and even commission aside, they know that the 5 years that in the at least for the money for the commission that's not within the program for youth, if you realize, we moved it with, I mean, relative to the approved budget, we multiplied it by 4 times in terms of showing the emphasis I mentioned. And yes, you are right. The current commissioner for youth says it all the time that the youth are run out of capital in the villages, in the, all the ones of the Tanzanian communities. And therefore, program of youth that we have, we are going down to the communities, and as you said, the most vulnerable, especially women, and so on. Now, on FOCO, pay refuse direct to government account, excellent. I agree. You would be a of the but I don't have to pay, but we have to die. Okay, in my view, we must work very hard to give our kind of face to go. And one major thing, because in my emphasis on that, is that we began to clear the village about the proper government house and the governor's one. As governor of Anambra, I'd like to live in the capital city of Okan and work in Okan. And when we're working towards that, and therefore the slums, the Okan and so on, I get with that. Mananji Okan, the Tonya,
I can throw myself at the DPU and myself at the chief. Thank you.
you are talking about, suddenly I get the reality. Once of my bypass that can be congested traffic, that's of priority to us. Two, the fire service, uncompleted fire service was vandalized at Anko. Thank you for drawing our attention to that. Ask everybody to go and look at that. But let me also say something about fire service. We are now decentralizing our fire service from being controlled at Oka to now get down to the local government. The local government become the ones that are in charge in terms of operations and monitoring. So we'll get that and see to what extent that cohesion with the plan Oka. The running fire service spread from Oka has been, in our view, inefficient and ineffective. And now we are sending them all the fire trucks down to the local government. Yes, new moment and implementation of that, we are aware of it. We actually had operations that combined over the weekend, and more will come. And we'll come down. There is quite a bit of it. Roles to be played by the communities. So this is the point we're getting down, by the communities, by the individual. But if I need the information, there is an unknown government. They are not unknown government. They are known. First role in Kukuwebia. Send us the name, send us the phone number or whatever, we'll go and pick him up. And get their information, they try to get people. And a lot of our people are responding. And I want to thank all of you, the Anambra, very bold, courageous. Those phone numbers are very close to me. In fact, as I am sitting here now, five of them are around me here. So as you send this off, we are getting the message direct, and we are dispatching response to those places. But then we will come down to the communities, those communities, the people that made that, send us who they are, we go after them. Now, on the onion about IPO, Epos Drive, and so on, and not Epos Drive, the truth of the matter, you must know, I said it on my my inauguration day. When you want peace, you must prepare to dialogue with everybody who can contribute to this process. Anybody and everybody who can contribute to the peace process will dialogue with the person, will get the person engaged. The same Nandekar, you had him yesterday after the first meeting, calling for peace and in the southeast, that the place should be quiet, that this the same thing that we have been saying, that if you are making, if you are having agitation, if you are having whatever, it has nothing to do with going to kill your own people. That's the point we have to make. And some criminals have taken over this entire thing, and then all of them claiming to be liberationists and local agitators and all that kind of thing. Them as they are, the mechanics they want to come out on the one they are. In the choir, for a common democrat. So, it's a very long one. So, Fanny, then, Mamusiam, Moro, Dafana. So, when you open a guy, this is not going to open a money mafia. Buebe is a criminal. Let's draw the line. And that is what it is. So, now the camera has quite that basically calling on the same thing now, and reply to, I don't know what you mean by reply to represent. Let me tell you this. That's why we're in a democracy. And everybody is entitled to his own opinion. reply, I could when they don't have to also reply on their behalf. So if I hear when I say this is not this or something, somebody goes off the call in my own estimate, I also have a duty not just as a pastor, but also as a chief servant of the state, to also tell the pastor that I disagree. If I disagree, I disagree. Especially if it is done publicly, if you put out a statement publicly. And I disagree with that, and I think your statement has capacity to mislead the public and so on and so forth. I have a duty in a free world, in a free society, to respond. And so to that point, I have no, I have no apologies about that. Okay, I think that's about it. That's.
Clean environment on the honor, land, and you can handle
these things clear so we can make, so people can take a walk. The man who are here for that and take a walk. Provide for places of leisure, you know, relaxation and leisure, or they shall leave the air. Any other like that, I don't know what I'm talking about that, quite a few of them can take care of that.
And you came with disruptive thinking.
and the disruptive thinking requires paradigm shift.
Of charge, nobody will stop you, nobody will harass you. nobody is collecting any dime again from you. People are living for slavery at the central place. Full stop. In time, we will modernize this tax that you will carry the court in order. People that are missing here, the member of the level of the bank will be carried back. You know, the way back.
Thanks, Pastor. Yeah,
have service on Tuesdays for half the agenda. For Wednesday, you have the candidate. So this is and a lot of people who have come to Washington with us there, you know, point out that this is a new right, see that this is a, because we're going to change the language. Part of it is a nuanced in terms of how we, if we communicate together, we really don't see much what diffuses on our mind. At the end of the day, we want to run into a Rimoyana, 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 how do you watch it? You know, I do Rimoyana, but well, that's what I want to say. Anambra people of all the combinations of the world, that we can come together with a laser focus on transformation, transforming this place into a liberal and prosperous movement. That is the mission. And I don't think I'm not giving aid in terms of the people that we're asking to do serve and to do stuff. I'm not asking it. What value? If you have value to bring, please give it to the other one. When you have to pass in on this subject, as a group, one of the nominations that the election will get received at some point, way before I was one, I was discussing and I said, you know what? You got the election, you get the nomination. Don't get the nomination. I don't get it. Get that this world and the whole world will come out. I think it will be costing just back on the envelope, probably up to $300 or so million. How I want on Kuroa, the bank, this year. Then we're going to deport it. I also like marginalize that and put up that foundation. Then we'll be deporting. Marginalize that and everybody else. And if you don't,
Thank you.
Doing it actually be head and shoulder above everybody in the competitive process.
Yeah.
They will do better than everybody else. In terms of academic qualification, they have it, teaching experience, they have it, and so on and so forth. So somebody who has this probably goes through the aptitude test, date, and so on and so forth, and scales through. Then you go for the interview, having even been teaching yourself. You do better than a fresh graduate who is just showing up. And I will give you an demonstration there, Chika. And this is a personal experience, because I also run a school. I run a public school with a doctor. And at some point, I had about 15 graduates when I was there in that school. And one of the recruitment exercises that advertised around Ethiopia and the environment, and mostly it was PTA teachers that applied, 76 or so. Applied, then we were trying to recruit, I think, 76 of them applied, mostly graduates. And it wasn't just an interview, an oral interview. They went through an examination, written examination. Chika, do you know the exam they were given? They were applying to teach in primary school. They were given first school living certificate exam questions for English, Maths, and Igbo. And guess what? Only about 11 of them or so passed. Only about 11 of them passed. But they have never PTA teachers teaching in school. With no disrespect, you know, I'm a teacher myself, and I'm always inclined to be very emotionally inclined at that to anyone who is a teacher. I think teachers should be encouraged and motivated and everything. But there is another act, which is to make sure that those who are going into that to do that job are the best that we can find. So why do we do the recruitment and restrict it only to those who are already PTA teachers? Okay? What about some others who have not been PTA teachers, but that even have the skills that we require to teach in those schools, and but they have not been PTA teachers. But now they want to do formal teaching. Why don't you give everybody a chance? That actually is the point here, that we've decided to be fair, to be transparent about it, and to give everybody who has the skills, who has something to offer, a fair chance to compete, rather than just restricting only those who are already in PTA, who are already employed as PTA teachers. That's a very restrictive sample size to select from. That is the point that we're making, that little PTA teachers have, and I have, I think there are two persons who are I received one dress of X message, but I was really this big. This person who sent me text, he's gone through the first phase and gone through the second phase. It's one of them said he's gone 65 in the second phase of the exam. I said, fair enough. So now, you now go for the interview. So you are part of the cutoff. You go for the interview, and you should do better than the, if you like, the JJC, as it were. And that is the kind of transparency we want to bring to bear in public affairs. You know, very young Chika with a master's degree
Thank you.